military weapons. Today we talk about the counter-rocket artillery mortar known as the CRAM, Indirect Fire Protection Capability System. It was developed early, during the Operation Iraqi Freedom, Enduring Freedom, in order to protect ground forces and forward operating bases from the threat of rockets, artillery, and mortars. CRAM is made up of a variety of systems which provide the ability to sense, warn, respond, intercept, command and control, shape and protect deployed forces. A main component of the CRAM system is the LPWS, which is modified from the U.S. Navy MK-15 Mod 29 Block IB Baseline 2 Close-In Weapon System and mounted on a commercial 35-ton semi-trailer for land-based operations. The M6-1A1 20mm Gatling gun is capable of acquiring its target and firing at a rate of 4,500 rounds per minute. The Forward Area Air Defense Command and Control, known as the FAADC2, integrates the sensors, weapons, and warning systems for the CRAM intercept. CRAM was operationally deployed in Iraq and Afghanistan, where its sense and warn capabilities provided timely warning of more than 2,500 rocket and mortar attacks against CRAM-equipped forward operating bases. CRAM was also purchased by Australia and the United Kingdom. Of its mobility, it's highly mobile with a mounted-on road mobile platform. It protects deployed troops from rockets, artillery, and mortars, and was previously deployed in Iraq and Afghanistan, then purchased by Australia and the UK. Produced by Raytheon, Northrop Grumman, L3 Communications, and Lockheed Martin. Tests show that the CRAM had a 60-70% shoot-down capability. On December 16th of 2004, Tardex Active Defense Systems team conducted test simulations and activities. The first activity involved a live interceptor being loaded while waiting for a live mortar to fall within the engagement range. This was followed by Mortar Tracking Systems radar, providing IAAPS a cue. The system then tracked the mortar, computed a fire control solution, fired, and then updated the fuse timing in flight, and the interceptor appeared to engage the mortar nose to nose at the prescribed standoff in front of the mortar. CRAM used target acquisition sensors, including Firefinder and lightweight counter-mortar radar, to detect and track fire rounds. The ANTPQ-36 Firefinder radar system is produced by Northrop Grumman's Electronic Systems Sector. Once a threat is detected, audio and visual alarms sound to warn exposed soldiers. Then, a fire control subsystem predicted the mortar round's flight path, prioritizes the target, activates a warning system, and then provides cueing data to defeat the mortar round while it's still in the air. The complete CRAM system networks a ground-based version of Phalanx together with the Army's lightweight counter-mortar LCMR and a Q-36 target acquisition radar, known as the ANTPQ-36 Firefinder radar. Unlike the naval version, CRAM does not fire solid tungsten penetrators. Instead, it has a self-destructing explosive bullet that's used in order to reduce the risk of civilian and friendly casualties. The fire control subsystem Northrop Grumman Mission Systems provided for CRAM uses software that's modified from the FAADC2, which ties together the sensors and weapons of the Army's short-range air defense battalion. Northrop Grumman was the first contractor for FAADC2, which is operational throughout the world and has been especially critical to homeland security efforts in the Washington, D.C. metro area. You'll find more specifications in the description below. Also, be sure to subscribe and turn on your notifications for more in the future. Thanks for watching.